Welcome back, boys and girls. Today we're continuing with the Great Adventures of Big Nate. And it's chapter 4 this time. Hey, Nate, taking a nap? Or are you doing the world's slowest push-up? That's Teddy. Just ignore his lame jokes. I always do. Teddy's my other best friend. Francis is number one because I've known him longer. But definitely is Teddy is definitely number 1A. He's awesome. I'm not sure about him at first. That's the way it is with new kids. You sort of check them out for a distance to see if they seem cool or not. But you don't want to be all Joe friendly to them right away. Because what if they turn out to be total losers? Here's a Teddy fact. He taught me how to say Mrs. Godfrey is fat in Spanish. Señor Godfrey is traza. Si. And here we are, total losers. Would you like to see my nasal spray collection? Some random new kid. Okay, what am I saying? But Teddy was tough to tell. On his first day at PS38, Principal Nichols asked me to show him around the school. Teddy was all quiet and serious. He barely said the word the whole day. I've told Teddy plenty of times since then he seemed like a total dork. Can this kid even talk? And he and I were paired up for a science lab. We were supposed to dissect a squid. We were about 5 minutes into it when Teddy picked up our squid, pretended it was a giant booger. Anybody got a tissue? It was hilarious. I started laughing. And then Teddy cracked up too. That was the first time I've ever heard him laugh. Sounded like some sort of crazed laugh. Honk, honk, honk. Oh man, we lost it. We were laughing so hard that we dropped our squid on the floor. Then Mary Ellen Popowski stepped on it, which made us laugh even harder. Ooh. That's when Mr. Gallon saw what was going on. Wow, is he mad? He went full Godfrey on us. Glossary, when a teacher completely snaps and starts screaming, it's called a full Godfrey. When Mrs. Godfrey does it, it's called, well, Monday. He made us clean the squid guts off the floor. We apologized to Marianne, but I guess we didn't sound sorry enough, because she kept whining that her shoes smelled like dead squid. I said maybe that was a proof of how they smelled before. Then I had to apologize to Marianne again. We had detention for 2 whole weeks. You get in trouble that bad with somebody, and it changes the way you think about them. When I saw Teddy dangling that squid from his nose, I figured he was okay. And after we did those detentions together, I knew we were going to be friends for life. Raise you guys to the flagpole. But that doesn't mean I'm going to let him beat me to the flagpole. Ha! My turbo speed is taking over. I got to run this race by a mile. Uh-oh. Wham! Holy cow, Principal Nichols. This could get ugly. Principal Nichols is Mr. Discipline. He doesn't stand for any horse around. Here I am, body slamming on his way into the building. Stand back. He's about to explode. I'm sorry, Nate. I wasn't looking where I was going. That was entirely my fault. Like I was saying, Principal Nichols, what a great guy. Are you all right, he says. Yeah, it didn't hurt, I tell him. You're sort of like a giant airbag. That is, you're kind of cushiony. It's not like you're all bony and stuff. What I'm trying to say, I'll just stop talking now. Move along, son, says Principal Nichols, looking like son is the last thing he wanted to call him. Phew. Sure. I'll be happy to move along. Thought he was going to hit me with detention for sure. Come on, guys, says Francis. Only a couple minutes till homeroom. Hang on. I got to put away my lunch. Quick. I have sort of an organization problem. One of these days, I really need to clean out my locker. With a dump truck, or maybe a match. But no time for that now. Let's see here. Where's my lunch? It's not here. You gotta be kidding me. I ran out of the house so fast this morning, I forgot to stick my lunch in my backpack. I groaned. No problem, Teddy tells me. I got you covered. You do, I ask. Yep. He says we went out for Chinese food last night. Tons of leftovers. Sesame chicken, spare ribs, a couple egg rolls. Here. A fortune cookie. A fortune cookie. I like getting my fortune told. I'm way into horoscopes and magic eight balls and stuff like that. By the way, I'm a Scorpio. That means I'm dynamic, loyal, and chock full of animal magnetism. In other words, I rock. What's your sign? But fortune cookies bug me sometimes. Fortune telling means predicting the future, right? But half the time, fortune cookies don't tell you anything about the future. They're just lame sayings. Sometimes they're boring. Large life is a series of small events. And sometimes they're just stupid. Here today, gone tomorrow. Plus, the cookies taste like styrofoam. Sometimes, like the time Dad took me and Ellen to Poo Poo Panda, they make absolutely no sense. That one was so bizarre, I drew a comic about it. Here, kids, fortune cookies.
Oh, mine says your wish will be granted.
And mine says, what the? A milk can will frighten snow monkeys.
What does that mean?
Who cares? The important thing is my fortune was good. We may never find out what it means, Nate. And we never did. What a ripoff. I guess you could say I've got a love-hate relationship with fortune cookies. I hardly ever get a good one, but I still can't resist cracking them open. Wow! Well, that's what I call a fortune. Today, you will surpass all others.